Hello class, welcome to College Success. This is Dr. Mahoney. This is an instructional video to help guide you through your assignments throughout this course. So each assignment section or module, I will present a very brief video so that you will know the direction you should follow. So today we're just going to focus on the intro of the class. As you can see at the top, there is your course number. So you want to make sure that you are always logging into the correct course number. You may have registered for other College Success courses, and you may have made changes to times and things of that nature, but your final course number that's listed on your banner schedule is the correct course number that you're active in. So this happens to be a summer 2017 College Success course, section number 400. 120 FRO for freshman studies and course number CRN 20194. This is just an example. This may not be your course number, but just know that yours will be listed there as this video may have been recorded prior. So my name is listed, and as you can see, your information on your courses should be listed as well. So let's take a look at the first module. So if you'll follow my cursor, I'm going over here to the side. This is how your course looks when you first log in. The first modules are the square content that will guide you through your course assignments. So welcome to Southern University at Shreveport is your first module. In this module, I've provided you my contact information and just a brief welcome to the course. Here I have listed the announcements. So you want to pay close attention every time you log in to the announcements. There will be various times when I will place announcements for you. Any updates, changes, or any technical difficulties that I'm noticing will be listed in the announcements. Encouraging you to continue your progress maybe in the announcements, and anything that I feel that is of great notification to you will be identified in the announcements. Here we have a College Success student course guide, the instructor's welcome video. So I have a welcome video for you that's breaking down our objectives for the course. And then we have news forum, and if you have any questions or answers for me. That's the welcome. I'm going to shift over to the left side of Moodle. Here are some great resources for you I want you to be familiar with. Let's see if we can get back up to the top. Okay, so on your left side, we have some color-coded areas. Here we have people, which is going to identify all of the participants, your colleagues in the class. We have navigation. This navigation panel allows you to jump from one area to the next. Participant badges we will not use. Competencies. And here's the grade book, which is very important. So you will have access to your grades as they go along. There will be assignments that I will have to download and grade and upload a grade for you. And there will be quizzes that will automatically place a grade in your grade book. So I'm just going to click on the grade book so you can see what it looks like, and then also to show you how to maneuver back. So I am the instructor, and this grade book may look a little bit different than yours, but yours should look something like this. And I have some grades there and some names, so I'm just going to kind of scroll over here. So grade book should have the introduction, should have all the assignments that are due, the new student orientation, syllables, quiz, etc. So for example, when you complete the assignment, you should see a grade like here pop up if it's an automatic grading process, or you will see me place a grade in shortly after. It typically takes me about a week to get everything graded and uploaded for each assignment. But if you do not complete an assignment, you will see a zero, or you may still see it blank, as sometimes I leave some of the assignments open for you to go back. So if I clicked on academic team, for example, inside of the grade book, then it's going to take me that to that particular assignment. Now, how do I get back to the main course? I'm going to recommend you simply click up at the top on your class to get back. Okay. So kind of pay attention to gradebook. And then of course we have all of the modules that will be listed under the, what section is that? Navigation section. So this kind of helps you navigate the system. Any module that is not open and available to you, such as the electronic library resource, for example, it's not opened anymore, so you will not be able to click on it. The plans of career success is not available for you at this time because you have not gotten that far yet in the course, so I will not have it opened. And sorry about the shakiness. I am holding this with my hands, literally. Administration, you may not have this part, but I want you to pay attention to activities. This is a very important section. This section will help guide you through everything that's required for you to complete in the course. Assignments, you have forums, lessons, quizzes, and resources. So if we click on assignments here, when we click on assignments, it will list every topic and assignment and due date that you have to complete for this course. So this is a great resource guide for you to flow and for you to double check to make sure that you've completed your task. And it will let you know what your grade is, and it'll also let you know that it was submitted as well. Okay. So you have your assignments. I'm going to go back. Alrighty. Back to activities. You have your forums, which are important. Some of the assignments are listed as forums, which are actually discussion boards. So you're welcome, of course, is one of them. Announcements are there. News forums, if we have any questions, will pop up. The learning forums are your discussion board assignments, so you will be responsible for those. So if you needed to confirm if you completed one, look in this section and it'll tell you. If not, click on the blue area and it will take you into that particular discussion, and here's the directions for each discussion. And that's an area that you must complete by the end of the semester as you follow your modules in the order that is listed. You will have completed all of these. So I would recommend the last week of class or so, the last 2 weeks of class, go ahead and double check these sections to make sure you have completed all of your assignments. Those are little tips to help you succeed. And then, of course, you have your quizzes. Anytime you see, and these are the icons. So anytime you see a little assignment being delivered by hand, that's an assignment that you'll have to upload. When you see the statement icons there, that's a forum where you will have a discussion. Lessons, we don't have any lessons that are in this type of category. The quizzes have a check next to them, and then resources are all your reading materials and things of that nature. Okay, and then it has your courses listed. That's the most important aspect that I want you to capture. Well, you're welcome. Now, I have placed what is called an assignment timeline inside of Moodle. And basically, the assignment timeline is just a great helpful tool for you to navigate this course. So I have all of your dates and your deadlines listed there. Under your checklist, these are your actual module numbers. It tells you what the module title is, the assignment that's due for that module, how many points, and it provides you with a quality due date. So if you follow the due dates on this timeline, follow the exact assignments on this timeline, you will be and you will remain on track with the flow of this course. Now remember, an online class requires self-discipline and it requires you to manage your time effectively. So the purpose of the timeline is to help you manage your time and complete your obligations for this course in order to achieve your goals. So no one should be off track. Now, one thing about the timeline that may confuse some people, I want you to understand this. The areas that are blue and on the timeline, these are actual quizzes that I've structured in the class. You can click on those and go to the quizzes, but I do not want you to do that because you might think that these are the only assignments that you have to do. Everything under assignment section here is required for a grade. So even the areas that I cannot click on is required for the grade. Well, Dr. Mahoney, why isn't it highlighted in blue? Because Moodle only captures the quizzes that I placed, not the actual assignments that have to be uploaded. So I do need you to go to each section. So for example, let's go back up to one. For example, let's go to Rewards of College. We know that is section 3, module 3. We know we have 3 assignments, not just the 2 in blue. 3 assignments, they're all due on a certain date. So when we scroll down, Introduction is there, Getting Started. We're looking for the Rewards of College. There we go. Section 2. Make sure that I am getting there first. Sorry. Okay, Section 2, the Rewards of College. I know that my timeline said I had 3 assignments. So the first thing you're going to do is read the overview, your student learning outcomes. I also have Voices that you can listen to. They're reading this information for you. They're not showing up on this, but you should see them. You have your readings, and you can click on those options as well. You have your PowerPoint. This week's task is going to let you know what's required this week. This particular section has your textbook. So your textbook is a free online textbook offered by Sailor. And all you have to do is just click on the module tab, and it's going to open up the textbook. So this is, for example, this is taking you to the chapter. Hopefully that's relating to that particular module. So it takes you through all the different chapters here. Okay, and I think we're looking at the first. We should be looking at you and your college experience. So you do not have to purchase a textbook for this course. We use a free open online resource. Okay, let's go back to the class. I think I clicked out of it. All right, so I'm having to do the back arrow to go back into Moodle. And I have to do it as many times as I did it. So these are the little things right here, like I'm having to click right back a couple of times. There we go, to get back in Moodle. So don't get lost in that aspect. And I'm actually went too far, so I'm just going to go back up to and start over. Okay, we're back. So here are your assignments.
in section two. You have your call it success syllables at which you would open up, review it, and then come and take the check, which is a quiz that is built inside of Moodle for you. Click on the quiz and take the quiz. You have a new student orientation PowerPoint to review. You have a new student orientation quiz to take. This is where you're earning your points. You have the rewards of college, and then of course you have a discussion. So anything with a check is a quiz for points generated on your grade. And anything with a text conversation box is a discussion that's also generated for grade. All of our assignments are worth 20 points except for your final assignment. So let's click on our quiz real quick so you'll know how quizzes work. Here's your quizzes. It's giving you a brief description of your quiz and how many points it's worth and how many attempts. So each quiz may most likely have two attempts that I've set up. And it tells you how long the quiz will remain open. So that's going to be your deadline to complete your quiz. So each quiz may have a different deadline, so make sure you're paying attention. The time that you have is 1 hour. And the grade method, we're going to take the highest grade. Okay? And then you can, I don't have access to this, but you would have take the quiz and then it will start timing you. And once again, you have two opportunities to take the quiz. So I am actually going to go back using the arrow button this time, showing you a different way to get right back to where you were. And we are back. So once you've completed all of your tasks for that module, then you're done. Okay. Very, very simple. I'm just going to refer you back to the timeline once again, which is the second module, and all of the great dates that you have. We should have 13 to 14 modules in this course. And then also on that sheet is your textbook once again. So you can utilize this electronic textbook, read the sections as you go along, read the chapters related to each module section, and you should be well on your way to a successful grade for this course, which is the goal. I'm Dr. Mahoney. Thank you for spending time reviewing your initial assignments for college success. I'll see you at the other side of an A.